Okay, now one from the Get What You Pay For department. Consumer reporter Randy Riplinger has become an expert on China today.
Not the one that has the wall, the one you eat off of,
right? Glad.
And I'm still really not much of an expert, but we found some people who are, because we wanted to know if an ad that came stuffed in yesterday's newspaper was the deal of the century or not. China for sale, 45 pieces for only $49.95, kind of a good deal. That kind of set in fine porcelain china should usually cost at least $400. Admittedly, these guys are keeping their overhead down. They sell the stuff out of the back of a truck at a Beaverton motel.
We've had, hundreds of people out here.
The businessmen selling these Chinese china sets say they picked up 21,000 cases of the stuff 2 years ago. They've been traveling around the U.S. selling it in parking lots ever since. They're only in one spot for a couple of days, so one wonders how you make a return. Well, if you do it very quickly, there's no problem.
Well, my daughter don't like the color. She likes everything except the color.
The woman got her china exchanged, no questions asked, because the salesman just gave the same box to the next customer who came along.
There you go. I got it right here for you. Where do you want to put it?
So we went inside the motel to a room used to temporarily display the china. There were a few other people there looking at it too. A few of them made a purchase, so did we. The guy at the truck checked our receipt, and we were the semi-proud owners of a $50, 45-piece china set, which we promptly took to Bill Nalbert at Friedlander & Sons, since I don't know china from a doggy dish.
It's rather opaque, and the finish on it isn't very good. Like this spot that you can see on the side of this. This would never pass in a fine china operation.
The dishes were made of a coarsely ground material, says Nalbert, demonstrated by the fact that you can see light through fine china. The $50 version is too dense.
Would you call this fine china?
No, not at all.
And there were many other flaws. The decal was painted on top of the glaze instead of vice versa. The plates were kind of warped, too. Shouldn't be too much trouble unless you fill them real full. So, how much would they sell for in a store like this?
Well, it would be termed a promotional item. I mean, it could be given away with other merchandise under promotion. It would be very, very low cost. I don't know of too many stores that would actually have it on their shelves to sell.
Our China appraiser estimated the set might be worth $25 to $60. So if you buy a $50 set of china, you get a $50 set of china. But Lenox, Noritake, and Mikasa, it is not. Just wanted to know what you were buying before you rush out and get that out of the back.
Okay, so $50, you may get kind of a cheap set of china, but how much more do you really get for $400? Isn't there a lot of markup when you go to some of the better stores?
That's right. I thought the stuff we looked at was pretty nice looking, but we talked to a retailer today who admitted that the middleman marks it up 3 to 4 times before it even gets to the retailer. So it does go up. So one other point you might want to know, that china usually is not made in China. Usually comes from Europe or Japan.
Of course, that's why they call it China. Thanks, Randy.